doing fanfics number four. No, I just realized something. I really haven't done a video where I read fan or read creepypastas. Like there are a bunch of fanfics that are labeled as creepypastas. So really, they should be fair ground for me. And the first, it's on the piece that I'm gonna be writing. Reading is on the troll pasta wiki. Oh joy! Wait, what's going on? It's my wall behind me. What's that?
Swirls wear an eye.
He's right behind me, isn't he?
Hello!
Oh my swirls, who in tarnation are you?
Well, the name's not an aspiring internet reviewer. Now, Louie, okay? Who might you be?
Well, Mr. Ned, my name's Komasan. Swell to meet ya.
Oh, Komasan, you seem to be fit to be ready in my Amelia L 100 subscriber special, or I guess 152 subscriber special. But anyway, it's a subscriber special or milestone special. So yeah, you want to be in it?
Well, I guess so.
This episode of the Creep Pop that I'm reviewing is Disney's Carnage. Stuff by Tales Dollar or 2 and Hugh Quee the Tisk Boy. Now, first off, I gotta say, I don't mean any ill will to the authors of any fan. I don't mean any ill will or offers. The offers for a fanfic I review, keep on and keep improving, as Little Warm Havoc would say. Oh, so yeah, Ian Fanstrive did review this creep pasta in their top 10 worst Disney creep this video, which I will put the link in the description. So yeah. Dude. Also, this is on the troll pasta wiki. So I see we're gonna be in for a bad time. Sounds rules of screw it, why not? I'm gonna try to visualize the stories through stuff I made in Photopea and MS Paint. Those are Photopea. Here we go. Disney's Carnage.
Wait a minute, Mr. Ned, I think I know why I've joined you. I reviewed a creepypasta in the past called Pokemon Gold and White Edition.
Okay, so I have a creepypasta review on my side. I'm reviewing my first creepypasta. That'll be great to have! Anyway, let's actually review Disney's Carnage.
Hey there. Have you ever heard of Warner Splatter? It's a party theatering animated Warner characters Tom, Jerry, and Looney Tunes dying in brutal ways. If you have seen by chance a picture of Jerry getting chopped by Tom, it comes from that demented party. Well, I had a terrible experience with something like that. First things first, let me introduce myself. Name's Susie, and I'm an anthropomorphic Danuzar. I used to be a bully, be mean to everyone, frightening others.
Hold the heck up! Is this a Dolphin fanfiction? But like, it's supposed to be a lost episode creepypasta. But it's a fanfiction, so shouldn't this be a Grimdark fanfiction? Come say what you think.
I don't know.
Yeah, I guess so. Makes no sense either. Let's continue on the story. Since I put this on camera. This video has been delayed. This video is delayed to heck and back. And I really just want to get this video finished.
But an indirect trip to another world changed me completely. That's not what I'm gonna talk about, Thought. It was Saturday, and I was grounded for skipping class yesterday. Not that I cared a lot. I lied to my parents because if I told them the true reason why I skipped class, they wouldn't believe me. I was in my bedroom when our house phone rang. My dad picked it up, and Toriel was on the phone. She wanted me to go to school because I was with Chris when we weren't gone for a long time. When I went there, Toriel was really pissed off.
Mind you, explain me, what did you do with Chris yesterday?
She say it. Miss Toriel, I promise, I didn't do anything to them. Oh, I might have treated them, but nothing more. Ain't smart. Then I told her the real reason of our disappearance. Unfortunately, that made her more pissed off.
Are you fucking out of your mind?
She screamed. I was shocked. Toriel had never sworn, not even in front of a student.
I can't believe you have been doing drugs. That's illegal and wrong.
She kept screaming. I swear I didn't do drugs.
Well, if you are going to keep lying, then I will have to get them off.
As she dragged me tensionally, he said, Carnage. Marker. Just... She is a monster. That's gonna go. Okay, so it's this. Basically, Lamp was Buzz and just song gets dead by a spiky rock. Drum Ridge. Okay, now let's get back to the freaking abortion of a Deltarune fanfiction. Okay. Just torture me. When? And see? Well, she done? Just... Scar me. Okay, first off. Okay. First off, this is incredible. This is, you know, freaking piss yourself at a crappy Disney Pixar movie. Gorefest. Like, she deadass Chris's face in chapter 1. And in all honesty, I thought she would get a kick out of this. And also Tornado Field's character as well. She's supposed to be a loving goat mom, which but was probably a mate attachment-ish. She was, Also, I swear to God that Zuli didn't have parents, really like attention. Like, if you know about psychology, you know the bully y'all because attention like the parents or something, I don't know. Also, now let's get to the comments. Well, actually, Susie, enjoy it. Go. Okay. Kid. So, Hugh Queen was... wiki. Oh crap. This may... It's a hole. Now, like, this would be like... I wouldn't like, you know... Oh, if it wasn't... just only about in Stars and Hula Hoop ones and bad Disney creepos, you know, but the fact that it became it's a freaking fanfic on top of that, it just makes me question just how is humanity just that point. Also, if you want you could have just, like, I don't know if this should be classified as a grimdark. The last episode passed that, if he's considered. Jeez Christ. Well, that's pretty wrapped up. But let's get on to the conclusion.
In conclusion, this pasta is rubbish, which I think is a bad start. This is the first creepypasta, or like, pasta I reviewed, and it's bad. Hopefully, I will get a review, you'll get to review, like, better pastas in the future. So, this pasta gets a 3 out of 10 for actual serious stuff. And it's like a negative 8 out of 10 for being ironically hilarious. So, that being said, catch you later. And thank you for 100... Hold up. How many subs do I for 280 subs. I can't thank you guys enough. Now, I've been doing this out of, like, passion. Let's aim for, like, 500 subs as next milestone. See y'all later on next episode. I gotta say, you're a great lad.
Gee, thanks, Nick.
Like, seriously? I'm very sure you'd be a welcome addition to this series.
I hope so.
And I gotta, like, fix my hair.
I am the Arnai, that has acquired a new bow. It shall become the wings of rebellion, that breaketh thy chains of captivity. With the breath of the starved sun, I have obtained the wings of blessing that shall lead to freedom and new power. Or stand I guess whatever floats your boat.
Do you hear something? Does my measure? Oh! Shoot! Sure.